हे गाइस, वेलकम टू लीप स्कॉलर। सो आप 11th या 12th स्टैंडर्ड में हैं एंड यू प्लानिंग टू स्टडी फॉर अ बैचलर्स डिग्री अब्रॉड। स्टिक टिल द एंड ऑफ दिस वीडियो बिकॉज दिस वीडियो इज गोइंग टू कम इन वेरी हैंडी व्हेन यू सिट डाउन एंड प्लान योर बजट एंड फाइनेंसेस ऑफ स्टडिंग अ बैचलर्स डिग्री इन ऑस्ट्रेलिया, यूके और कैनेडा। इस वीडियो में आई विल डीकोड ऑल द कॉस्ट इन्वॉल्व टू स्टडी प्लस योर पार्ट टाइम अर्निंग्स एज वेल। सो विदाउट मच फर्दर डिले, लेट अस डाइव स्ट्रेट इन टू द वीडियो। Right, so before we start this video, I would like you to have a look at the Excel sheet which is flashing on your screen. So this Excel sheet mein we're going to talk about three major points. Number A is your expenses, B is your earnings, and C we calculate your effective cost, which comes from A minus B. And for the sake of calculations, I'm presuming the value of pound to be 100 rupees, Canadian dollars to be 55 rupees, and Australian dollars to be 53 rupees. And before we actually start putting in the values, we also need to know what all factors we're going to consider. So in your expenses, I'm going to talk about your IELTS fee, your IELTS coaching fee, your tuition fee, living costs, airfare, everything included. And in your earnings, we talk about your part-time earnings when you work 20 hours a week during term time or jab aap vacation mein kaam kar rahe ho 40 hours. Uske bhi we'll add the value and then effective cost hum calculate karenge by subtracting your earnings from your expenses. So let us start with the Excel sheet. Great, so let's start with our IELTS coaching fee. So if you take IELTS coaching from an institution outside, it's going to cost you somewhere around 5,000 to 10,000 rupees per month. But if you enroll with Leap Scholar, our programs start at just rupees 99 for 4 weeks program. So at the stretch, if I take into consideration, if you take more time to prepare, at the stretch, you will spend close to 1,000 rupees for the IELTS preparation. So let me just add that value here. So for IELTS, you're spending 1,000 for each country. Great. Next up, we have our IELTS exam fee, which you have to pay to IDP India. And that's a flat 14,700 charge for that. The IELTS fee is similar for both computer-based and paper-based test. Great, so we have the equivalent values in GBP, CAD and AUD as well. Cool, so next up we have our application fee. So application fee for all the countries vary. For UK, let us assume you're applying through UCAS. And for UCAS, you have to pay a standard fee of £26 for 5 universities. So let me just add the value here. For UK, it is £26. For Canada, every institution has a different application fee. So I would advise you to apply to at least 3 universities. So you already always have a second option. So averaging $100 as the application fee for one university. For 3 universities, it will be $300. Now comes Australia. So Australia, a few universities like the top ones would have certain amount of application fee to be paid, which will be around $55 se leke around, it goes up to $80-$90 as well. But I think most of the universities in Australia are free. So we're presuming the application fee for Australia as zero. Next up, we have the tuition fee. So tuition fee for every country, again, it varies. UK ke liye, I would say £12,000 per annum is an ideal amount. So UK mein 3 saal ki degree hai. So for £12,000 in 3 years, it will be £36,000. Next up, Canada. Canada mein 4 saal ki degree hai aur ek average fee, I would say, is around $25,000 per annum. So 25 ke hisab se, 4 years ka program would be around $100,000. And last, we have Australia. Australia ki tuition fee is somewhere around $26,000 on an average per annum. And for a 3-year degree, it will be $78,000. Okay, so tuition fee ke baad, the major chunk of our expenses go into the living cost. So to start with UK here, living cost for UK, I'm assuming £11,000 per annum, which is the minimum recommended by the British High Commission and the UK Border Agency. But do note that the expenses can be a bit high as well, depending on your spending habits. So for the whole duration, that is for 3 years, it will be £33,000. Right, so next up we have Canada. $10,200 is the GIC, which is recommended for 1 year. Multiplying it by 4 gives you $40,800 Canadian dollars. And for Australia, $21,000 is the recommended amount by the Immigration Australia body. And for 3 years, it will be $21,000 × 3, which is $63,000. Great. Next comes your visa fee, which you have to pay to the respective high commissions. आपके स्टूडेंट वीजा एप्लीकेशन प्रोसेस करने के लिए यूके के लिए द फी इज £348 फॉर द वीजा. फॉर कैनेडा इट इज $150 एंड फॉर ऑस्ट्रेलिया द वीजा फी इज $630. सो देयर वी हैव द रिस्पेक्टिव वैल्यूज फॉर आर वीजा फी एज वेल. Great. So after your visa fee, you have to go for a medical test as well for all three countries. So UK ka medical test ke liye you need a chest x-ray and TB. So that is around 2500 rupees. That's an approximate value. It keeps on changing. For Canada, it's approximately around 6000 rupees for the medical. And Australia, it hovers around 5000 rupees. So I'm just averaging 5000 as the value of the medical test. Next up is your IHS insurance or OSHC. IHS is basically applicable for the UK. IHS ka matlab hai immigration health surcharge, and that money has to be paid aapke health insurance ke liye while you studying in the UK. So total for 3 years plus jo aapka visa 3 years ka hoga plus ek threshold thoda additional time hota hai uske upar. उसके लिए द टोटल IHS फॉर अ थ्री ईयर प्रोग्राम इज £1645. सो दैट यू वुड हैव टू पे फॉर यूके. कैनेडा में कुछ प्रोविंसेस आपको हेल्थ कवर देंगे, कुछ नहीं देंगे. सो आई एम एज्यूमिंग द कॉस्ट हेयर टू बी जीरो डिपेंडिंग ऑन विच प्रोविंस यू गो टू. सो यू डू रिसीव सम सॉर्ट ऑफ हेल्थ इंश्योरेंस और नॉट, सो यू कैन बाय इट अकॉर्डिंगली. For Australia, the OSHC, the Overseas Health Cover, is average, I would say, $1,600 for the whole duration of your program. Next up is your air tickets. So air tickets, we are assuming one-way ticket, and we are assuming that you book them at least 2 weeks in advance. So peak travel times mein, September or July, jo ऑस्ट्रेलिया और यूके और कनाडा के इनटेक्स हैं सितंबर, जुलाई, फरवरी एंड जनवरी, उसमें जो टिकट्स हैं वो थोड़ी एक्सपेंसिव होती हैं. सो आई एम अज्यूमिंग 30,000 एज योर वन वे टिकट टू यूके, 50,000 टू कनाडा एंड 50,000 टू ऑस्ट्रेलिया. सो दिस प्राइस विल वेरी डिपेंडिंग ऑन विच सिटी यू लिव इन. सो इफ यू हैव अ डायरेक्ट फ्लाइट देन ऑब्वियसली द काइंड ऑफ यू नो टिकट्स यू विल गेट दे मे बी चीपर then maybe taking connecting flights or longer flights. Now we have the total expenses here. So for UK we have around 71 lakh rupees, for Canada we have 78 lakh rupees, and for Australia we have 76 lakh rupees. Right, so next up let's talk about our part-time job se earnings. So part-time job ki aapki jo wages hain they will differ from province to province, from city to city. But I'm assuming an average value for all three countries. So for UK, you can expect somewhere around £7.50 as your 7.50 as your part-time earnings per hour. And for Canada, I'm assuming $15. Or Australia ke liye, I'm assuming $16 per hour. So hamare paas respective values aa gayi hain. So agar aap 9 महीने काम कर रहे हो 20 आवर्स अ वीक विच इज़ ड्यूरिंग अ टर्म टाइम, यूके में आपका £5,400 बनता है. फॉर 3 मंथ्स जब आप 40 आवर्स काम करते हो देन यू कैन अर्न अराउंड £3,600. टोटल आपकी ईयरली इनकम इज 9,000 एंड 3 साल के लिए 27,000. ऑल्सो वी आर एज्यूमिंग कि आपके जो एंटायर ड्यूरेशन ऑफ द प्रोग्राम है उसके लिए आप काम कर रहे हो. सो बेसिकली इफ योर डिग्री इज लास्टिंग फॉर 3 ईयर्स यू वर्किंग फॉर 3 ईयर्स एज वेल. So this is an ideal situation, a best case scenario. It will vary from person to person. For Canada, aapki jo yearly income hai, that is around $18,000 approximate, and 4 saal ke liye $72,000. For Australia, aapki jo yearly income banti hai $19,200 and 3 saal ke liye $57,600. Okay then, so we have our final values here. यूके की 3 ईयर डिग्री इज गोइंग टू कॉस्ट यू समवेयर अराउंड 45 लाख रुपीज, इंक्लूडिंग योर लिविंग एंड ट्यूशन. कैनेडा इज गोइंग टू कॉस्ट यू अराउंड 38 to 39 लाख रुपीज, एंड ऑस्ट्रेलिया विल कॉस्ट यू समवेयर अराउंड 46 लाख रुपीज. हेयर आई वुड लाइक टू एड वन पॉइंट कि ये जो आपकी ट्यूशन फी है, इट विल वेरी एज पर द इंस्टीट्यूशन एंड द प्रोग्राम. सो टेक्निकली इफ यू आर स्टडिंग अ प्रोग्राम इन इंजीनियरिंग या साइंसेज या आईटी, वो आपको ज़्यादा कॉस्ट करेगा एज कम्पेयर टू से अ प्रोग्राम इन आर्ट्स और ह्यूमैनिटीज और बिजनेस. सिमिलरली मेडिसिन, लॉ, वेटनरी साइंसेज और डेंटिस्ट्री जैसे प्रोग्राम ज़्यादा एक्सपेंसिव होंगे. सो दिस वैल्यू मे डिफर फ्रॉम पर्सन टू पर्सन. ओवरऑल अगर हम तीनों को कंपेयर करें, कैनेडा टर्न्स आउट टू बी द चीपेस्ट ऑफ द लॉट हियर. सो कैनेडा में 4 साल की डिग्री, ऑल दो ड्यूरेशन थोड़ी लंबी है, लेकिन कैनेडा टर्न्स आउट टू बी द मोस्ट अफोर्डेबल डेस्टिनेशन फॉर इंटरनेशनल स्टूडेंट्स. राइट, सो गाइज यू कैन यूज दिस एक्सेल शीट एज अ रेफरेंस पॉइंट फॉर योर बजट प्लानिंग टू स्टडी अब्रॉड फॉर योर बैचलर्स डिग्री. लाइक आई सेड, इसमें आपकी वैल्यूज जो मेजर चेंज होंगी वो होंगी आपकी कोर्स में, बिकॉज एवरी कोर्स वुड हैव अ डिफरेंट वैल्यू, डिफरेंट फी. And plus, कुछ universities की fee is expensive, कुछ universities की fee is low. So that will vary as per your choice of program and university. Also, अगर आपको कोई help चाहिए with your financial planning or budgeting, you can always get in touch with us. You can book a counseling session by following the link below, which is given in the description box. Hope you like today's video, and do like this video and give a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. I will be back with another one soon. Until then, take care, and I'll see you in the next one.